Good morning. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Riddler Studios. I am Jamie and it is Friday. And I'm so sorry that I didn't join you on Tuesday. I woke up with a sore throat and I was on path to go ahead and do it anyway. And then I just realized that what always works best for me when I feel unwellness approaching is to just smother it with rest and love. And so that's what I did. I just curled up and let my energy go towards healing. And I've been tired this week, but I have not succumbed to sickness. So far, so good. Knock on wood. How are you doing? How has your week gone? What have you been up to? I have been up to a lot. Maybe you heard the podcast yesterday. If not, I'll leave a link to it so you can check that out. I am nearing the end of my meditation instructor training. And yesterday I had the experience, the great experience of offering instruction to my teacher, Susan Piver. And I wanted to mention it this morning because in the podcast, so the podcast is the before and this is the after, and the podcast is filled with all the angst and worry I had about the experience. And it's tough to teach your teacher. At least that's what I thought. But in the moment, in my experience, I did not feel that way at all. I felt the great blessing of spending time with somebody who I respect and admire and care about, somebody who is near to my heart. We had that time together. I offered instruction and it was lovely for Susan and I to sit together. And yes, I received feedback given with love and lightness and precision, and it made me a better teacher. It was worth it. It is worth it to go through the discomfort because on the other side lies knowledge and also often surprise. The experience was not what I anticipated being at all. It was wonderful. And I definitely learned. And that's the key point. In our creative lives, we are going to get uncomfortable all the time. Learning is one of the reasons, risking is one of the reasons, sharing is one of the reasons, how we feel about our work is one of the reasons, how many of us have felt uncomfortable with what we're creating. Bam! You know, I know I have felt uncomfortable with what I'm creating in lots of different ways. One is, you know, what's pouring out of my heart may not be in line with my self-image. You know, it might be either too edgy or too cute or too something, you know, and then the one we all experience, and trust me, we all experience it, is noticing the distance between what is in my head and in my heart and what is on the page or, you know, on the canvas, on the dance floor, that they don't sync up. In a way, this makes entire sense to me because you are, in your creative process, doing an act of translation. There is a language that goes on in here, a fully airy, fiery language that is inspiration and thought and anything's possible. And the world speaks a different language. When we bring something into tangibility, we're starting to translate it into the language of earth. And we're taking all of that and pouring it into something. It will necessarily be transformed. And the best advice I have heard on this is from Linda Berry. And it was that, you know, it is a great idea to detach, to forget, to do a sort of willful act of forgetfulness about what it was we started with, and instead give ourselves a chance to fall in love with what has arrived. And she does that by taking time away from it, you know, not ditching it, not leaving it, but coming back to it in a week, in a month. And then usually by that point, as we look at what we created, we're actually able to see it for what it is, not for the distance between what we thought it would be and what it is. And that is a powerful gift. I wonder how often that actually would apply to, I went straight to people, but I think situations too, where our upset, our anger, our disappointment, our frustration is coming from a place of having an expectation of who or what that situation or person should be, and discovering that that's not, in fact, the truth of this moment, and being like, but I want it to be the truth. I want it to be like this. I thought it was like this. I relied on it being like this. This isn't how it is. So I think the most powerful creative work of our tangible creativity or of our lives is finding our way to working with the given circumstances. And maybe pouring our frustration, our anger, our truth, whatever it is, into those circumstances and allowing them to be what they are and also be transformed. This is the thing about our creativity. Creativity is magic. It has the power of transformation. When we bring our fresh thoughts, our new ideas, our willingness to do the work, our willingness to trust our intuition and see what's in our hearts and express it, all of this becomes transformative power. So one of the other places that I have been experiencing great transformation is in going on my daily walks. This has just lightened my mood. You know what? And I'll be working to stay with that even through the colder weather. We have our first dusting of snow today. And so suddenly there becomes whole new barriers for, I don't want to go outside. It's cold. It's rainy. It's dark. I'm going to work with that. And I'm going to remind myself that getting outside has lightened my mood. And it's done so not just because of the physical activity, because of the connection to nature. Even in a big city like Toronto, there is nature everywhere. There is the sky wherever you look, the sun, the moon, the stars, the trees, the leaves, the grass, the falling leaves, the weeds. There is nature everywhere. And it is a blessing. And I feel not only blessed by nature, but also by people who look at me with a friendly face and say hello, by people who don't, but are offering up their energy in the world, buildings, houses, signs of human life, toys left at the park, things left on the stoop, cats, dogs, birds, raccoons, squirrels. The world is rich. The world is full. So opening up my eyes is a practice. It is one of my very deep creative practices, is paying attention to the world around me, and going on a walk gives me a chance to do just that. And though I know a lot of people say that using your camera all the time or having your camera handy all the time is a way of distancing yourself from the experience, I also find it is a way of bringing me right in to the experience. I am paying attention closely to what I see, to what is here. I'm looking up, I'm looking around, I'm looking down, I'm looking in front of me, I'm looking behind me, and paying attention. So whether going on a walk for you sounds like a good deal, like a good thing, whether you do that already, or whether you're like, walking is not the best activity for me, I invite you still to open up the awareness through your eyes of what's above you, what's below you, what's around you, before you, and behind you. Pay attention and see what you see. Grab your camera and take one picture from me. Oh, and below you too. One picture from each direction and get a sense of exactly where you are. So there's a little creative project for you today or this weekend. And speaking of creative projects, somebody I know has done one. I have received another cat yet. Meow. Let's see. Let's have a look at our little treat today. One cat for our pride. And I got a request to do a little scan of the cats, and I will do that. And be sure to check me out on Instagram. I like it often to do that there. Oh, look at this, Jet and the moon. Yay! Oh, look at Jet. So let's hear. This is from Michelle. Hey, Michelle. Thanks so much for sending Jet our way. Jet is, it's not late. This is well on time. We are doing this until I will be wrapping up the BTS, usually the first week in December. So as long as you get me something before then, it is on time. So Jet is in good time. And Jet is her cat. And he loves to sit on our windowsill at night, especially on moonlit nights. Oh, wonderful. Well, he is going to have a wonderful time sitting on the bulletin board, too. I just know it. Thanks, Michelle, so much for sending us Jet from New York. It's awesome. I hope Michelle and all of these cats are inspiring you to make a cat and send it to me, too. The address is at the end of the BTS, and I always look forward to your creations. Every cat that arrives is well loved. So I look forward to seeing what you create. Speaking of creating, I wanted to share not only a book, but also an artist I am wildly in love with right now, which is Jane Davies. Now, Jane Davies is obviously, you can see, she is an abstract painter, and this is her book on abstract painting. Abstract painting is not something I have particularly pursued, but when I came across Jane's paintings on Pinterest, I just fell in love. And Shannon and I, my sister Shannon and I, were looking at the paintings yesterday and just talking about them. I've been trying to figure out what is it that I love so much about Jane's work. And some of it is the energy, some of it is the color, some of it is the shape. Jane has several videos that you can watch. I'll give a link to her YouTube channel. And she has several videos where she shows her process, and she has a very dynamic energy as she's working. And I talked about this on Start Creating As We Go. One of the things that it made me get in a visceral way is that painting can be a movement practice. And so the idea of like really moving with line or creating shape or spattering energy really excites me and makes me just want to do it. It makes me excited about the process. And also too, one of the things I think that she does too, she, at least in a lot of things I watch, she does a lot of tone on tone color stories. And I love that. And though there is a great sense of energy and color, I don't know what it is. I find it her colors incredibly dynamic and yet also incredibly harmonious. And so I am crazy for the work. I immediately bought this book, Abstract Painting, The Elements of Visual Language. And I've only just started it, but I wanted to share it with you because I think it talks about sort of art principles in an accessible way. And I think sometimes these sort of art school art theory things get glossed over or missed. And I think we can learn so much. She's talking about the elements that make up composition, breaking it down into line and exploring all the things you can do with line, and then shape and all the things that you can do with shape, which is innumerable, right? Mass, pattern, and texture. I mean, if you're conscious of these things and if you are developing pages and studies and compositions using these elements consciously, I just don't think you can lose. Besides, I don't know about you, but it seems tremendously fun to me to say, you know, I'm going to spend an afternoon exploring texture. I'm going to spend an afternoon exploring shape. You could spend your lifetime, as artists do, exploring these things. Anyway, I wanted to share her with you because, as I said, I'm wildly in love with her art. And I think that she's offering something up that is very useful, interesting, and fun, which is a great combination to me. I hope it is also a great combination to you. So if you can, go for a walk. Whether you go for a walk or not, see if you can open up your awareness through this exercise of take a picture in front of you, behind you, above you, below you, and all around. Notice where you are right now. Create a cat and send it to me. And maybe explore a little bit of Jane's work and think about line, shape, texture, pattern, and mass, and how that might apply to your creative life. And check out the podcast. There will be some useful tips for you if you are in that awkward stage of learning that we all reach sometimes. I think I packed a lot into today. What do you think? I hope that makes up for missing Tuesday. I always miss you when I'm not here. Have a wonderful weekend in your studio. Remember, your life is your studio. I will see you on Tuesday.